I grew up in a small town, Central California, and the movie theaters there didn't show, much beyond Bridge on the River Kwai and The Blob. So I didn't really experience foreign films until I found my way into film school. And at that point is when I was actually exposed to Kurosawa. And a friend of mine, John Milius, actually was a huge fan of Kurosawa's. And so whenever the film was showing, he'd say, "Oh, you gotta come and see this, you gotta come and see this." And after the first one, the first one I saw was Seven Samurai, and after that I was completely hooked. I said, this is really good. You're not gonna find really a lot of filmmakers that have the facile quality with the medium that Kurosawa had. A lot of things happen within a frame, and then at certain points he'll go and he'll do lots of cuts. But he does know how to play a frame out. He uses long lenses, which I happen to like a lot, and it isolates the characters from the backgrounds in a lot of cases. So you'll see a lot of stuff where there's big wide shots, lots of depth, and then he'll come in and isolate the characters from the background, and you'll only really focus on the character. So he used a lot of camera techniques to kind of get to the point. The one thing about Hidden Fortress is it did influence me in doing Star Wars, because as I was beginning to write the screenplay and put it together, I remembered Hidden Fortress, and I remembered the one thing that really struck me about Hidden Fortress, and I was really intrigued by, was the fact that the story was told from the two lowest characters. I decided that that would be a nice way to tell the Star Wars story, which is take the two lowliest characters, as Kurosawa did, and tell the story from their point of view, which in the Star Wars case is the two droids. And that was the strongest influence, actually. The fact that there was a princess trying to get through enemy lines and everything, I think was more of a coincidence than anything else, because in my film, the princess is more a stand-and-fight kind of princess. There's a book written and a theory among writers that there's only 32 plots, and that it's all the same 32 plots retold. And in a way, I'm not sure that's exactly true, but once you get into writing stories or reading stories or studying the whole issue of stories, you find out that most stories are repeated over and over again. I know Kurosawa was a very big fan of John Ford's, and that he was very, very influenced by John Ford, and you can actually see John Ford's influence in Kurosawa's films, which I think is one of the reasons that they are so accessible to Westerners. It caused him a lot of grief in Japan because of the fact that he was Western in his orientation and storytelling. He was not extremely well regarded in Japan, especially in the beginning. And it was really once his films were taken out of the country and put into international film festivals and that sort of thing that they begin to get recognition that I think the Japanese begin to soften in their attitude toward his style, because it was a little more emotional than they were used to having them be. And there was a very obvious Western influence from really the great American Western directors. I think somebody asked Kurosawa once, "What is in your movies? What are they about? Why are you making them?" And he said he's always trying to answer the question, why can't people be happier? And why can't they be happier together? And I think most filmmakers are dealing with issues and questions like that, which are very basic human questions.